Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, and thank you for joining us on this solemnity of the Annunciation, where the angel Gabriel announced to Mary about the coming of Jesus' birth 9 months from today. Mary was asked to be the mother of God. Do you want to do that? And she, of course, said yes. So for the times that we haven't always said yes to God, we pause and ask God for pardon and peace. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and human may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to Ahaz, saying, ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld or high as the sky. But Ahaz answered, I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord. Then Isaiah said, listen, O house of David, it is not enough for you to weary people. Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Sacrifice or oblation, you wish not, but ears open to obedience, you gave me. Holocaust or sin offerings, you sought not. Then said I, behold, I come.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll, it is prescribed for me to do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
Your justice I kept, not hidden within my heart. Your faithfulness and your salvation I have spoken of. I have made no secret of your kindness and your truth in the vast assembly.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sin. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocaust and sin offerings you took no delight." Then I said, "As it is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God." First he says, sacrifices and offerings, holocaust and sin offerings, you neither desire nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Word of God became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we saw his glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel then said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for she who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary replied, "Behold, I am a handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
today's gospel, Mary could have easily been troubled in the sense of, great, here I'm expecting a child now that I've said yes, right? And she's going to have, quote unquote, the Son of God. But then the angel adds, oh, and by the way, your relative is also having a baby. Now, I was thinking recently, you know, and I forget where it was one of my relatives where someone was expecting, but they were going to the wedding and they were told, don't tell anybody because that'll take away from the bride's big day, or you know, and you hear that all the time. Okay, I'm supposed to keep this, we've been trying to have a baby for 10 years, and now I'm pregnant, now we can't tell anybody because somebody's getting married. Well, we do that out of charity, right? But in the sense of Mary and Elizabeth, Mary wasn't jealous. Mary wasn't troubled in that sense. What happened, sort of the next passage after this, probably in Luke or one of the other authors, is that Mary then went to visit Elizabeth and stay with her and help her. So she wasn't trying to compete with her. Little did she know at that point that Jesus' cousin, John the Baptist, would go before him to prepare his way. We know that from the Advent story. We know, of course, that 9 months from today, we'll celebrate the birth of Jesus, which always confused me. Here, we're still in the midst of Lent. A few more days, and we'll be in Holy Week. But that's the way our lives are, right? We're always juggling different things on the calendar, different events in our lives where someone is pregnant, someone else is getting or just got married. It's not a jealousy. It's not a competition. It's out of love for our family and friends, and of course, out of our love and our duty to our Savior, and our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the next few days will go through his passion, death, and resurrection. And of course, that is why he came to be born. And that is why we can celebrate today, this most special day. Because Mary said yes, we can say yes to God in all our troubled times, in all our troubling situations. So perhaps our prayer today could be something to the effect that, that we can pray and be as accepting as Mary was those 2,000 years ago.
Let us say our Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Mary knew that nothing was impossible for God. We lift up our prayers to our Heavenly Father with the same faith and confidence.
That all the baptized live their faith with Mary's loyal dignity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of nations defend the right to life of each person, especially the poorest and most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The victims of oppression and injustice be strengthened in their struggle to live with dignity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That pregnant women receive the necessary nutrition and care for safe delivery of strong, healthy babies. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who gather at this table find in Mary inspiration to renew their faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the names in our book of prayer petitions and in the perpetual mass book in our three worship sites, and for those who have died, especially those who have died during this pandemic, and we remember all in our one faith community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All-powerful and eternal God, you guide us to your justice, love, and truth. Grant what we ask by the power of your Holy Spirit, in the name of Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, but through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, that will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let us come up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that the Christ was to be born among humans and for humankind's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly, she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promises to the children of Israel might come about and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him, the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and gave you thanks, Father, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world.
For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Lord, with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Holy Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son and confirm us in the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, Howard, our Bishop Emeritus, with all other bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and with your entire people, grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of your holy gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way. Remember our brother Michael and all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Elizabeth, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
every people. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a couple of quick announcements. Adoration at Sacred Heart Church tomorrow has been canceled, so unfortunately. And then we will have confessions, those of you who missed it, at St. John's tomorrow from 2 o'clock until about 7 p.m. You can come in the main entrance of the church or into the sacristy where I'll be hearing confessions. And then also, the reservations for Palm Saturday and Palm Sunday are closed and are full. So you'll have to watch it online at 11 o'clock or later in the day on Sunday. And then also for Easter Vigil on Saturday at St. John the Baptist Church in Greenville at 7:45 p.m. There are still limited seats available. The 9 a.m. here at Our Lady of Knox Shrine in East Durham is full, so that is not available. But there are limited seats at 11 a.m. in Sacred Heart Church in Cairo. So, that's it. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Our Lady of Knox.
Intercede for us.
St. John the Baptist.
Pray for us.
Have a great day, everyone.
Thank you, Father.